Engine libraries and screening. Today we will discuss about screening procedures. So let's see what screening is. Screening is actually the process of identifying one particular clone that contains the gene of interest from among the very large number of clones that are present in the gene libraries. We perform screening by different ways, from which one is nucleic acid hybridization. In nucleic acid hybridization, we use nucleic acid probe to screen the library that based on the hybridization with nucleic acid. And the other is analyzing the protein product. So, screening procedures involve first screening, and the other is colony and plaque hybridization and expression screening. In expression screening, we analyze the protein product and hybrid arrest and release, and the final is chromosome walking. First, we discuss nucleic acid hybridization. Actually, hybridization is performed to identify the interested DNA or its RNA product. In hybridization, we use radio-labeled probes, which is complementary to the region of the interested gene. Probes are oligonucleotide primers that derive from the sequence of a protein product of the gene and the DNA fragment or oligo from a related gene of another species, and then blotting the DNA and RNA on membrane, and then hybridize the labeled probe with DNA membrane or RNA membrane. In colony and plaque hybridization, we transfer DNA that present in the colony and plaque to the nylon membrane or nitrocellulose membrane, and then phage DNA bind directly to the membrane. And bacterial colonies must be lysed to release DNA on the membrane surface. And then hybridization is performed. After hybridization, we wash it to remove the unhybridized probe and then visualize it. Here we use film that is radioactively labeled. And in case of colony, we use antibody or enzyme, and then line up the hybridized region or repeated hybridization. Here is our master plate that contains the clones having our desired gene of interest. We transfer colonies from that master plate to the nitrocellulose membrane by replica plating, and then we denature DNA and we bake the membrane, so our DNA must bound tightly to the membrane surface. And then we add P32 radioactive labeled probe that are complementary to the gene of interest, and then we expose it to the film. When we expose it to the film, we see that spot present. It indicates our desired gene of interest, and this figure describes the complete scenario behind this screening. First, we cleave the cellular genome with restriction enzyme, and these are bacteriophages. We extract phage genome and then we cleave it. After cleavage, we use DNA ligase to ligate our desired gene of interest into the phage genome, and they become recombinant DNA. Then we transfer this recombinant DNA to the phage head. Now, these phages will infect the bacterial cells, and inside bacterial cells they replicate themselves, and after lysis they form plaques. So here is clone of bacterium and phage clone in plaque. These are library of phage clones having desired gene of interest. Next, we place nitrocellulose membrane to this clone of bacterium having our desired gene of interest. So next, we incubate filter with radioactive labeled probe. The radioactive labeled probe hybridize with its complementary sequences, and then we expose it to the X-ray film. After expose it to the X-ray film, they show a bright band, and we confirm that our desired gene of interest is present here. So These are our desired clone. Then we infect fresh bacterial host with these phage clones. Next is expression screening. In expression screening, we identify the protein product of an interested gene. Expression screening is carried out by checking protein activity and Western blotting using a specific antibody. If the interests are cloned into an expression site, it may be expressed, and therefore we can screen for the expressed proteins. However, this screening may miss the right clone. Here is the procedure for expression screening. Here we use antibodies to screen the expression library. First is plaque lift, that taken by placing a membrane on the dish of the plaque and then immersing in a solution of antibodies. Antibodies bind to the antigen and then we detect it by other antibodies, and we repeat cycles of screening to isolate our pure plaques having our desired gene of interest. Next is hybrid arrest and screen. Individual cDNA or pools of clone can be used to hybridize to messenger RNA preparation. In hybrid arrest, we translate the messenger RNA population directly, and the inhibition of translation of some product detected. In hybrid release translation, we purify the hybrid and the hybridized messenger RNA release from them, and they are translated, and it defines and it identifies the protein encoded by the cDNA clone. Next is chromosome marking. Chromosome marking is actually a method of positional cloning that used to find, isolate, and clone a particular allele in a gene library. In chromosome marking, we obtain overlapping genomic clones that represent the progressively longer part of a particular chromosome. We perform chromosome marking by preparing a probe from the end insert, and then that probes are used to rescreen the entire library by cloning or plaque hybridization, and then they analyze the new isolate clones and posted them relative to the starting clone, and some will be overlapping. And then we repeat the whole process using a probe from the distal end of the second clone. Let's see how we perform chromosome marking. Here is our fragment 1. We isolate DNA fragment that contains the known gene or marker gene near the target gene. So we isolate this fragment, and then we prepare restriction map of this selected fragment, and we subclone the end region of the fragment, and then we use them as a probe. Then hybridization of probe with the next overlapping fragment. So preparation of restriction map of fragment 1 and subcloning of the end region of the fragment 1 to use as a probe for the identification of the next overlapping fragment. And then we again hybridize it probe with the next overlapping fragment 2, and again we prepare restriction map of the fragment 2, and then we subclone the end region of the fragment 2 that serve as a probe for the identification of the next overlapping fragment. So all these steps should be continued till the target gene or up to 3 prime end of the total length of the sequence identified. Now let's summarize this procedure. First is we start with our known fragment, that fragment 1, and we prepare restriction map like this. We prepare restriction map, and then we use end sequence as a probe and prepare probe by subcloning, and next we hybridize clone in the gene library, and then we identify the overlapping fragment. So all these overlapping sequences are used to construct the genetic map of the chromosome and to locate the target genes. So chromosomal walking is a method of analyzing long stretches of DNA by a small overlapping fragment from the reconstructed genomic library. So it's all about chromosomal walking and screening procedures.